14, Lloyd Butler, Anna Melovich. For Butler, at 121, Kelly Shafowitz. At 127, Lloyd Butler, Leo Arabino. At 133, for Mars, Brandon France. For Butler, Gavin Rush. At 139, for Butler, Pierce Chop. At 1065 pounds, for Mars, Bernadette Vargo. For Butler, Ellie Jane Murray. At 145, for Butler, Legend Wilkinson. For Mars, at 152, Liam Hayne. For Butler, Dawson Davis. At 160, for Mars, Joe Satola. For Butler, Levi Donald. At 172, for Butler, Ren Michaels. At 189, for Butler, Matt Satan. At 215, for Butler, Mickey Crane Butler. At 285, for Butler, Landon Christie, for Mars, Aban Button. And at 10 and number, 60 pounds, for Butler, Sawyer Bagwell. For Mars, Avery Genetic. We will start the match.
Hello, everyone. This is Nathan Bodiger here.
And Stephen Green.
And we're coming to you live from Butler Intermediate High School Gymnasium. This Butler Golden Tornado take on the Mars Fighting Planets. It is, yes. Fighting Planets, right?
It is the Fighting Planets, okay. Correct. They have seemed to have a down year this year. Only have four guys on the team.
Yep.
I'm used to them. When I was in high school, they had like 25 guys, 30 guys, big powerhouse school, actually.
But we'll be propping up some of the wrestling action today with three different elementary bouts between elementary wrestlers from both programs. So mixed in today with our varsity wrestlers will be a few different bouts from the elementaries.
Mickey Cranebucker will take a forfeit.
Yeah, Butler's moving their lineup around a little bit, trying to get
Butler wins at 215 by a forfeit.
Trying to get certain guys to wrestle certain matches. So
205.
We were told right before the match that the starting heavyweight for Butler, Ethan Bebe, is actually out today. Landon Christie will be filling in for that spot. He's out there now wrestling Aben Budzilek. The official wanted those anklets.
I know.
Blue action was no good.
Thought he was coming to yell at me. Thought I was looking at him funny.
Maybe. Off the get-go, a nice shrug attempt there by Landon Christie.
Another one.
Yep.
Both ear to ear right now. Yes, yeah. Landon does need to improve his head position here.
Looks like a probably a pick attempt there. Low single.
Another shrug. Another
shrug.
Not super committed to it, but
I think Landon needs to move his feet a little bit more here. Get his opponent to move with him. I think he's the quicker, more agile wrestler. I don't know if taking a shot attempt under a 285 guy. I don't think he is 285.
Yeah, I think he's about 240 probably. Yeah. But there he goes. He got a takedown there with a nice little slide by. Yep. Not slide by, but drag out.
Good short offense there to take a 2-0 lead early in the first.
Inside bar, classic Butler. Yep, there goes Pry across.
He's got to be careful here. He's got to keep at least three, or at least 2 points have to be inbounds. If 3 points leave, just like they did just now, it's a reset.
Just like what happened right there.
Yep. Two back points awarded there gives us a 4-0 lead in favor of Christie. About 34 seconds left.
Yes, 34 seconds. We don't have the luxury of the second clock on today, so we kind of have to
swing out in front.
Yeah. Another inside bar going on here. He's going to pry that thing up.
Mars wrestler, Budzilek. He's staying pretty tough here, coming up to a base.
Landon Christie does not care. He's still going to get that pin, it seems like, if he has enough time.
Yeah, it's going to be close.
It's like 5 seconds left.
Did he beat the buzzer? I think he did. The ref's setting up like he did. So probably like half a second left on that.
Yeah, I think that buzzer went off right when he hit the mat.
The whistle and the buzzer came like boom, boom.
10 under 80 pounds from Mark Avery
Tenezic. All right, folks. This
Butler,
here's an elementary
match. This is
going
to be one of those elementary matches we talked about before. From Butler, we have Sawyer Vavro. From Mars, Avery Sitsanik. Saniak. Sitsanik. I don't know. S-Z-C-Z-E-S-N-I-A-C. I don't know. Figure that one out.
Yeah, something like that.
Got the elementary kids all clapping and stomping, cheering their teammate on.
Hyping them up. But the elementary kid is still nowhere to be found, so he's lost in that Butler pile somewhere.
There he is.
Look at him.
What a force this kid looks like. Actually, I like the Mars singlets. They're kind of catchy.
They are.
They grab your eye.
They do.
I don't know if our spectators can actually see either of these guys. They're both off the mat.
There he is.
Sawyer Vavro. I'm just going to call him Avery. Avery S.
Yes. Avery S. Here we go.
Good defense.
Good defense by Sawyer there. Lifts up the leg. Two takedown for Sawyer.
So he's got a deep, tight waist on the from the left side, working that ankle.
Still working that elbow lead, but to the wrong side, I think. Up. Uh-oh.
And a reversal is called there in favor of Avery from Mars.
Yep, 2-2 now.
Sawyer's looking to use one of those arms that's coming over top.
There he goes. He pops his head up. He has a double leg now. And doesn't get it.
Oh, and there's the hip and elbow roll.
Uh-oh.
And time expires. No fall was called.
What a roll, though, by an elementary kid.
Whoa, that was nice. It was well-timed.
Those elementary legacy practices, Coach Turner's been getting in there.
Yeah, that's right.
Because in elementary school, I didn't know a rule until I got to junior high.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's one of Butler's moves. We like to use it. It's a little more technical than what's called a fat man's roll. But
yes, not a fat man's rule. Don't say that in front of Coach Powell.
Yeah, he will be very upset. Here comes that arm over top again.
He's keeping a great base here. Head up.
Yes.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Our junior high kids should learn a thing or two from this elementary kid right now.
I agree. To his credit, Avery's got some good pressure on.
Look away and peel. Uh-oh. He needs to look away here. Danny does. There it is.
Very good defense on the bottom. He's got to be careful reaching back to that leg, though.
Yeah, I know. I wish he would just face Avery here and then stand up. I think 23 seconds left. Here he goes. Uh-oh.
He should at least have one. That should be two. Yep, there it goes.
Two there for Sawyer.
And you know what's interesting about these elementary matches, the way they do this here? The whole Butler Elementary team is just losing their mind right now, having a great time. And it's fun because when I was growing up, we had lineup v. lineup matches, just like junior high does, just like varsity. These guys have more of a tournament-style match system throughout the year. And so it's kind of hard for, like, the whole team to really get behind one guy out there on the match.
Yeah.
That makes this system really unique, the way
it
they
does.
Do this here.
You were able to line up in, like, a dual meet style in elementary school. That's crazy. We did it. Yeah, we had the tournament style when I was in elementary school, too.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just
I'm a little bit older than you, though. So.
You are. Just a tad.
That's kind of rolling around here, but it looks like Sawyer gets the reversal there.
I
believe we're...
11-2, I think.
Yeah. 11-2 here in the third period. Sawyer's dominating here.
He has locked up the major decision as of right now.
Nice going to that cross body breakdown. That's a nice advanced breakdown to know at this age, actually.
Yeah, that is. He's doing very well. Sawyer with the win, 11-2.
Alright, we should be back to varsity action, but as Steven said earlier, there's only four varsity wrestlers for Mars, so we're going to have lots of forfeits mixed in here.
Oh, we got another elementary match. Look at him.
Oh.
Look at him, he's an animal. Is he six and under?
You know what? This has to be Kellen Toner.
Oh, look at him.
Oh! 6 and under, 45 pounds. Kellen Toner, that's it. Yeah, we did loop back around here, and they are next on the agenda here. Looks like the other wrestler is still getting his things on. When you're that young, you can't quite trust these little guys to get their stuff on and be ready to go. You kind of have to... walk them through it a little bit. And that's what's happening.
Look at him. He's ready to go.
Yeah, Kellen, look at him, man. He's composed.
He is. This crowd doesn't bother him. Look at him.
He's already ready. He's in the stance.
Fist balled up, ready to go.
Yep.
Let's hope he doesn't throw any there, but I think he'll figure it out.
I don't even know if I want to say it on the stream, but DeMar's wrestler tripped over the mat a little bit. He's good.
He is good.
Minor adjustment here, and he'll be right there in the middle. Here he comes.
The rec specs are on, ready to fly.
Are those glasses or are they goggles?
I know. I think they're goggles. I mean, not goggles. I think they're glasses.
Yeah.
I pray that
I'm sure
it'll
be fine.
Oh, we got action.
Yes,
we have action.
Do.
Oh, here it is.
Kellen Toner. Double leg. No points scored yet, though.
What is going on here? Oh, he's on his back.
Well, something happened.
Something happened.
And Kellen has the takedown, and now he's getting back points.
I like the slow. I don't know what this...
Grab the body.
Parallel body lock. Oh, he's readjusting.
Mars Wrestler still fighting. Still fighting tough. The official's looking down.
I think he's pinned, but the official's letting him wrestle it out a little bit.
Yeah.
He's flat on his shoulders, but kudos to the official for letting the kids wrestle.
Yeah. Might have just been letting the kids get some mat time there a little bit.
I appreciate that.
5-0 Kellen here, and somebody took neutral. I believe it was Mars.
Oh, yeah, both men ready to go.
Oh.
Uh-oh. Oh, good defense.
Kellen recovers.
Good defense. Oh, no.
Hits him right back.
There he goes. He's on.
He says, I want you right back on your back.
Yes, that's where you belong. I think the kid is very pinned right now, but
yes,
the official is letting them wrestle the whole time. Oh, man.
I think when you're an official, it's kind of hard to call a pin on a kid this small.
I know. It would break my heart.
Yeah. Did he just ask the other ref what he's supposed to do?
I don't know. The kid is flat on, has been flat on his shoulders for 45 seconds.
Kellen's an absolute beast out there.
He is. In this hostile environment, it does not bother him at all.
I think Kellen's taking down there. Coach Roth giving the calls from the side with his assistant, Cade Savochka. The official there.
Oh, he reaches. Oh, he reaches back.
Set up. Oh, yeah, don't reach back.
Don't do
reach
that.
Reach back, Kellen.
But his athleticism does not fail. Is he going to roll?
Could we see another roll?
Could we? Nope. Oh, there he goes.
Turns around.
Oh, he's going to choke him.
Steps over.
Textbook.
Yeah.
The kid's on his singlet. Can't do that.
Official batted his hand away.
Kellen is just holding the kids back and just not letting go.
Yeah. I think at this point, we're already looking at a tech fall here if Fargo gets off his back. I believe.
Yes, it is 12-0 right now.
Yeah, and he's holding three back points. That's what he's holding the 3 points down there for.
Oh, I think. Oh.
So that would be a 15-0 win for Butler's Keller. Kellen Toner.
Yes.
Some pretty solid fundamentals there.
That was. Good match by the two young men. 107.
And they're already learning good sportsmanship.
They are.
Crossed and shaking the opposing coach's hand.
No tears from the Mars kid even after a tough loss.
Yep.
He just runs off the mat. And he's happy to be here.
Yeah. Butler's lone undefeated wrestler, Santino Sloboda, 21-0, is going to get a forfeit.
He will get a forfeit here.
We're going to have a few of these.
Tough match there, Santino.
Yeah. Anna Malovich getting the next forfeit at 114. Kelly Shockowitz at 121.
I don't think we'll have a match until 133, right?
That's right. And last forfeit here. Leo Irapino at 127. And here he comes.
133 for Mars, Brandon Prince. For Butler, Gavin Rush.
Gavin Rush.
He's coming out. The backpack, as they call him, as Coach Stoner calls him.
Rush coming in with a record of 14-7, but he's won some really quality matches. wrestled some close losses, specifically down at Virginia Duels.
Yeah.
It was good seeing Gavin take the first shot there.
Yes.
He's known to be a little bit on the back burner here in the first and on his feet. So good to see him being aggressive. Nice shot. He keeps moving, keeps improving.
Oh, double leg. He's shooting very far away.
Yeah, and to both knees. He's got to keep improving and continue his motion there.
Yes. Let's see if he can hit. And he gets the 2 points here.
Stoppage out of bounds. They're heading back in.
See if Gavin can get started on top here. His best spot, probably.
Mm-hmm. There's that tilt. I don't know if he's got quite 90. It's close. There's the first count. But you need at least two counts in order to start scoring points. 2 to 4 counts is 2 points. And then 5 consecutive counts
another
is 3
here.
Back points.
There it is. He needs to get that bottom leg up a little bit more, maybe.
Yeah.
But that's pretty good. That's pretty good there.
I think he's maybe relying on that kick up
from
his opposite side for trying to get the kid over.
Definitely.
Here comes a power half. That leg's not all the way secure, though. So
going to another inside bar here. He's probably going to try to go to a claw. Maybe not. Oh, cheap tilt.
Yep. I almost wonder if he was setting that up, making the Mars wrestler believe he was going into a pinner.
Yes. Now he's going to try to pin the kid here, probably. Oh, no, he's going to go to another tilt.
No, that's a reinforced wing. He could bring him over in a stack.
He's going to tilt side.
He is going to a tilt.
Yeah.
What am I talking about?
He's going tilt side there. Gavin Rush being very aggressive on his feet here.
Yes, he is.
And a chancery.
Front head chancery.
Scoop that head.
Now, if he goes... Okay, so he's stepping over here for more of like a double grapevine look.
Yeah.
Now he's stepped all the way through.
Oh, now he's a headlock.
Now he's sitting in that headlock position.
This kid's doing a great job of fighting off his back,
yeah,
though. As I say that, the ball comes for Gavin Rush. Right now, I think the team score is 49-0 it's going to be.
We're now going to be taking a break, so we want to introduce our elementary wrestlers.
Mason Haley, Mason Milbert, Brennan Hodgkiss, Tatum Keppel, Dominic Ikus, Cooper Rock, Braxton Murley, Wyatt Mack, Scarlett Stutz, Naomi Carlson, Bennett Miranda, Logan Murdy, Noah Hosley, Camden Minto, Colt Harris, Dylan Dickey, Braxton Long, Ellie Murdy, Colin Hodgkiss, Nolan Thurber, Henry McNamara, Alan Reiner, Maverick Piper, Caden Walker, Dylan Fox, Cooper Negley, Roman Alessio, Willem Meiser, Reed Lasitis, Caden Haley, Braden Milford, Connor Snyder,
you're good.
Emmett Smith, Cruz Chop, Caden Dietrich, Ike Collins, Isaac McNance,
Charlotte
Nolan Miller, Bryce Schreffler, Cody Eagleton, Riga Rummel, Xavier Byers, Blake Minto, Mason Helfel, Kyler Cole, Wyatt Craig, Caleb Fox, Blake Schreffler, Xander Caldwell, Ben Kinney, Finnegan Fielder, Dominic Snyder, Sean LaCamara, Nathaniel Wise, Noah Shuley, Jude Perhack, and Layla Crow.
Ladies and gentlemen, our 2023 Butler Elementary Wrestling!
We're back.
Yep, we're back. Flurry of forfeits there. Case Chop took a forfeit at 139, and Legend Wilkinson takes forfeit at 145. Looks like they're trying to get to the next varsity match here. So we have Dawson Davis from Butler on the left. And Liam Hine,
152.
Let's see if Dawson can get a good win here.
Yeah.
Davis, Caleb Mars, Liam Hine.
That's a good shot. One, two, uh-oh. rolling around a little after that nice high crotch. Oh, good shot there by Dawson. And good trip.
Oh. See, I'm not a huge fan of that trip style.
Yeah, that front
it
trip
does
thing.
Work for some people, but... Stoppage there. The headgear came undone.
That was a loud whistle.
It was a loud whistle.
Holy. Both guys hand fighting in the center. Another shot attempt. He's trying to do that trip.
Yeah, I'd like to see him circle to that underhook and use it a little bit more from the neutral position. Right now, front head and arm, he's looking to circle around. He's got that head low.
Oh, here he goes.
Got
he
it collected.
I think he has a cradle.
There, he's got two. Now he's going to lock that up. Yep.
Good cradle.
Get over. It's a little loose. The lock's in the wrong spot. The lock is kind of under the Mars wrestler's chest.
Yes.
Dawson wants it up by the neck.
Yes.
The best place to put that lock.
He still has it here. Nope, never mind. I lied.
Did score two back points there.
Yes.
So Dawson's leading 4-0.
There's about 25 seconds left in the period, I think, from what I can see from here.
Oh,
he threw a leg in him. Not sure Coach Schneider
tried
that.
To throw a leg again. Dawson forced him out here.
You think Coach Stoner taught him how to throw that leg in?
No, I do not.
I agree.
That had to come from a club or YouTube videos.
Dawson just needs to hold him down here for the rest of the first period. I think there's no time left.
A little bit of frustration there from... The Mars wrestler, Hine.
Yeah, you got to be careful. With too much frustration, you might give yourself a give a point up.
Yeah, you never want to give up an unsportsmanlike.
That can hurt you in so many ways.
Oh, so many.
Oh,
almost. Dawson really trying to fight and keep that arm from coming back on the left side. He's having a tough time keeping his head up while he's working to clear those wrists down there.
Yeah, he needs to do maybe a little bit more action down there.
Yep.
I would like to see him use his elbow to break that cross wrist or something.
Yeah. I think he's afraid to maybe pull that post up off the mat on the right side.
Yeah.
And get face planted. There he built a base pretty well there.
Yeah, he did. There he goes. Oh, he went for the head after a knee slide. Knee slide slash sit out. Uh-oh, Mars guy has a half here, but
yep.
Nothing to it, though.
Yeah, Hines doing a nice job at keeping his hips in good position, riding from a dominant position with his hips low.
He is doing a good job right now. He's riding this like inside bar 2-on-1, and that is a good stall call by the ref on our Butler wrestler there. He is not doing very much down there. As of right now.
Yep, Dawson gives up a stall call there. That's the first warning. A second one will award the Mars wrestler 1 point.
Yep.
Successive stalling calls will be more points.
What is it? 1 point? One more point? After one one warning?
There's another one. There's the point.
One warning. One.
That's some quick back-to-back stalling.
Yeah. What is it?
I think it's 1-1-2, and then I think it goes to a disqualification after that.
Getting stalled out.
Yep.
It happens in college a lot now. Not a lot, but I see it.
The rules have changed a little bit more to try and keep the pace high at the higher levels. They've certainly done that with the Olympic-style wrestling well, just to keep things moving. Dawson's electing to go down here. No, the Mars wrestler is electing to go down.
Yeah, Dawson elected to go down at the beginning of the second.
Yeah.
See if Dawson can put a good ride on here. Elbow lead. Trying to post it up on his leg.
Good tight waist there from the right to the left.
Yep.
He's trying to scoop that left leg in. But it is kind of a weak leg there. It wasn't threaded very well.
No, it was not.
Mars Wrestler doing a good job keeping his base.
He is doing a good job of keeping his base here.
But he's really not moving up off of that position very much either.
No, if I was him, I'd have a little bit of a sense of urgency here, which he has. And Dawson's
got to be careful. He could have got called for stalling too, and that would have been
another point.
Yeah. But with the escape, I believe we're 4-2. I'll just double check that score. Yep, 4-2. But the Mars Wrestler could benefit if he keeps this pace up and Dawson's unable. Dawson in on a nice
single leg lock
here.
Oh.
Mars Wrestler just went straight to his back.
Yeah, I don't know really. I don't know the technique behind that one there.
Yeah, I think maybe he thought he could throw Dawson, maybe a lateral drop, but Dawson was standing a little too upright for that. Normally you need a little increased pressure into you in order to throw that lat drop.
Yes. And I just saw the Mars Wrestler punch the mat again. I think he's visibly frustrated here.
Yeah, I think so too. And at this point in the match, that was not a great time to give up that type of takedown.
I think only 20 seconds left if I'm seeing the scoreboard correctly.
He could go big here though. He could go big. 6-3 right now, he's looking for a big move.
No, both guys, if I'm Dawson here, maybe I'm trying to get another takedown just for my confidence.
Yeah. I mean, he has done well from his feet.
His
weak point here in this match was probably from the bottom position, but I thought on his finishes, he maintained his balance well and his positioning.
Yeah, he did.
Our next weight class, 160.
Your guy, Levi Donnell.
Yes, it is. This is the man.
What's his record right now?
21-2.
For Butler at 160.
Yep, 21-2.
Levi Donnell. And congratulations to Levi Donnell. He has 100 victories, had 102 at the Virginia Bulls.
He has a cradle, a single leg right to a cradle.
Levi Donnell.
See what he decides to do here. Here they go.
Tried to drag his feet.
He did.
Didn't work.
Not a lot of room on the Butler mat on those sides there.
No. Levi probably still thinks he's a little guy.
Hey, we got the scoreboard turned on over there.
Yeah,
coach.
We did. 57-0 is the team score right now.
Oh, he has a cradle again.
Nice scoop in that left leg. Maybe trying to walk it up.
It's just kind of chilling out right. Oh, he's walking it up like you said.
His lock isn't ideal down there, and I think he's probably trying to avoid getting too high in this position, which he is, but he's balancing fairly well right now.
Yeah, he is.
And there's the fall.
And that will conclude the wrestling for tonight.
Yeah, I mean, we have
very quick
a couple more forfeits here. This will be... Who is this? Brennan McHale?
Yeah.
Yeah. Brennan McHale, who's a new wrestler, he's going to take a forfeit here at 172. And then Matt Zinkan taking a forfeit at 189.
And what is this team score going to be?
It's going to be pretty high.
I think it's going to be 80-0?
Yeah.
74-0, maybe.
The only thing throwing it off from a perfect score was Dawson winning by decision. So.
Oh, we have an elementary match.
We do have one more elementary match, yeah.
That's great.
Yep. And welcome to girls wrestling. It's a pair of girls here wrestling tonight.
Yes. I'd love to see the women's wrestling on the come up. It helps men's wrestling, too, bring attention to it.
Absolutely. Fastest growing sport in the state of Pennsylvania, maybe the country right now.
Yes, sir. Here we go.
Let's see, names. We have from Butler, Ellie Jane Murdy, and from Mars, Benedetta Vargo. I think all the kids... Nope, I lied. But two of the... Benedetta's younger brother, I believe, is that Thor Vargo that wrestled Kellen Toner earlier. I bet they're siblings. No? Vargo? Vargo.
It might be older.
Might be.
Yeah, because 10U and 6U.
I meant smaller.
Yeah, smaller. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe. Yeah, they do have the same last name. You'd imagine that they'd be related somehow. I guess they kind of look similar, too.
Yeah. 1 minute periods. Here with the elementary wrestlers. Vargo's working that half on the left side now. Close to a full Nelson, and it is called. Full Nelson is when a wrestler comes underneath both arms and puts them both on their opponent's head. That is what's called a full Nelson. That is illegal. A half Nelson, which is under one side and on top of the head, is legal.
Yes. Double half.
Double half, that's right.
She's building her base. That's good. Now she needs to step that she does. Step that outside leg up, and she is. Oh, she goes to a sit-out.
20 seconds to go.
Oh.
Ellie's trying to work out here, but Benedetta has a nice half in.
She does. Only 10 seconds. Oh, watch the full Nelson again.
She's hanging out up in that wheelhouse, and it's not a great place to be. Benedetta electing to go down for Mars.
Let's see if Ellie can put a good ride on here. Get it. Who knows? Maybe she's an animal on up there. We never know. And now it is 3-1. 3-1-er?
Yeah, 3-1 for the penalty point.
Oh, yeah. Oh, she
Ellie's got her hand on her arm wrapped around the head, not quite locked up in a headlock, though.
That's how she got taken down the first time, too. She tried to do a headlock and got taken down off of it.
Yeah.
She should bail,
Headlocks are high risk, high reward moves, and usually when you're in a close match, you want to avoid trying to throw one.
Oh.
Little scramble there from Ellie, almost flips over her opponent, but couldn't quite work her way out.
Going to a sit out here. Can she get up from it? I don't think as of right now. Oh, she's staying in a good sit out position, and that's the end of the second period.
Yeah, these periods are a lot shorter.
Yeah, they are. Man, it creeps up on you.
Yeah. Coach Roth and Coach Stoner both yelling at Ellie, don't do a headlock, don't do a headlock.
And she does headlock.
And she went for the headlock.
Maybe she doesn't know that it's called a headlock.
Maybe. That could be it. We're talking about young kids here. Both wrestlers either 10 years of age or younger. Officials looking for the fall.
I think she is pinned.
Yeah.
He let them wrestle a little bit, though. That's
well,
good.
Mars pulls off one win here tonight. Out of one of their wrestlers. I mean, they only wrestled
seven matches.
But, you know, 1-6 coming in here today.
75-0 is the final varsity team score, with Butler winning 2 out of 3 elementary matches.
Yep. All right. Well, thanks for joining us for this quick match here this evening. Yep. This is Nathan Bodiger.
And Stephen Green.
Hope you have a good night.